Hi, I'm Andres. In this short presentation, I will tell you about tangential flow filtration and how this method can be used to isolate urinary EVs, and then I compare this method with size exclusion chromatography. The motivation behind this study is fairly straightforward. There's always a need for a rapid and robust method to isolate extracellular vesicles. And tangential flow filtration devices can provide this rapid way, a rapid method to isolate EVs. And for those who do not know what tangential flow filter devices are, these are basically hollow fibers that are made of a filter membrane. And in this device, the analyte flows in a cross flow over the filter, which greatly reduces the danger of blocking the membrane, which is very common for dead-end filters, where filtrate is pressed across the membrane. And the benefit of this packing filter material in these hollow fibers is that you can pack them together in a very small area, many small fibers, altogether providing a large filtering surface area. This is another contributor to reducing the blocking of the filter. And one of the great benefits of TFF filters is their easy scalability. So we decided to see how TFF stands against size exclusion chromatography in purifying urinary EVs. In our setup, the urine pretreatment was left minimal intentionally. We only had a single 1200 G 10 minute centrifugation. And the supernatant of this centrifugation was then taken to either TFF based urinary EV isolation or SEC based urinary EV isolation. And in our TFF setup, we used two filters. So tandem filtration setup was used. The first filter had a pore size of 200 nanometers, and the flow through of this filter was then concentrated on the second TFF filter with a pore size of 50 nanometers. And after concentrating the urine on this 50 nanometer pore size filter, the sample was washed with PBS and then concentrated 10 times to provide the final sample. The whole setup takes roughly 15 minutes if you include also the 10 minute centrifugation. So this highlights how fast is TFF based filtration. Compare this to SEC, where separation of sample itself takes roughly 20 to 30 minutes, and then if you need to also analyze your fractions, you have to consider in that time as well, and also the final concentration step of your fractions. So clearly TFF provides a very rapid purification. So in the TFF based urinary EV isolation method, I analyzed the contents of different steps during the purification. There was input, then there was the large pore size TFF retentate flow through, and also the flow through of the final concentration step, and obviously the final concentrated urinary nanoparticles. You don't have to look at all of the numbers here, but if you are interested, you can pause the video to look at the details. But I would like to highlight that of the initial particles, we were able to retain roughly 60% of material in this particular verification, and eliminate 99.9% of the initial proteins. So this gave us fairly clean nanoparticle preparation. And if you look at the tetraspanin expression, and tetraspanins will tell us, so these are the EV surface markers, and their expression will tell us how enriched is our sample for extracellular vesicles, and we have a clear enrichment of now extracellular vesicles in the final 10 times concentrated urinary nanoparticle sample. So in this process we have been able to isolate urinary EVs. Now here on this Western blot image I have analyzed identical volumes from each fraction during the purification process, and we can see that the most abundant urinary protein, Tom Horsfall protein or uromodulin, seems to be concentrating in the retentate of the large pore size TFF filter. So 200 nanometer pore size is enough to retain uromodulin, which to me was a bit surprising. And if you look downstream at the concentrated and washed urine EV sample, we can see that EV internal markers such as ALIX and DSG101 seem to be highly concentrated in this fraction compared to any other pre-processing fraction. So this is also a very good indication that we have successfully isolated urinary EVs with this tandem DFF approach, and we have been able to eliminate uromodulin, one of the most common contaminants in urinary EV preparations. And in this EM image, it's also quite evident that the large networks of uromodulin are absent, and we have very clean preparation of urinary EVs. So now we compare TFF with SEC, and we compare urinary EVs purified with each method. As for the size profile measured by nanoparticle tracking analysis, there is no difference between the input urine sample and then EVs isolated with both methods. Same can be said for the yield, as comparing the average of three biological replicates of urine purified, EVs purified by DFF or SEC, we are very close to 50% with both methods. And purity index, even though slightly higher in SEC-based preparations, they both provide nanoparticles in the range of 10 to 9 particles per microgram of protein. And here is a gel image showing the input urine and isolated EVs by DFF and SEC loaded the same number of particles. Clearly visible how clean both preparations are compared to the urine input. And also if we now look more Western blotting data, both DFF and SEC based urinary EV preparations clearly have a concentrated EV internal markers, ALIX and DSG101. And if you look at the three biological replicates together, for example, the tetraspanin CD63 and CD81, they are also very comparable. And labeling the EVs with fluorescent tetraspanin antibodies shows that even though I didn't see anything with CD63 and CD81, which probably tells more about my capability of labeling them, but I can see fairly similar labeling efficiency for both SEC and TFF urinary EVs, which shows that again, it's for this property they are comparable. Now, as there have been reports on EV corona being different on EVs purified with different methods, I decided to also look at how, for example, lectins bind to these EVs purified by either TFF or SEC. And lectins are proteins that bind glycans, so in this case they should bind to glycosylated proteins or glycans on glycosylated proteins on purified EVs. And there's a slightly increased binding efficiency on SEC purified urinary EVs compared to TFF purified EVs. the same pattern still holds true in these three different biological replicates that I have used, with slightly higher binding efficiency of lectins to sec-based or sec-purified urinary EVs. And why this is the case, I don't know, but it seems to indicate that there are differences between TFF and sec-based urinary EV surfaces or coronas. And if you look at the tetraspanin expression on an ELISA plate, so this is basically a high binding plate where I have loaded equal amount of EVs and then probed for tetraspanin markers, there's a slightly higher signal seen with DFF based or DFF purified urinary EVs. Again, I don't know the implication, but at least it seems to indicate that there is a difference in the corona or accessibility of proteins possibly on the surface of these EVs. And finally, I also captured EVs with anti-CD9 linked magnetic beads, and this provided me a higher isolation efficiency for DFF purified urinary EVs compared to SEC. And I was also interested in how CFSC labeling efficiency is affected between these methods, and it seems that there's a higher CFSC labeling efficiency for SEC-based urinary EVs compared to DFF purified urinary EVs. To conclude, TFF is a very rapid and simple method for nanoparticle isolation, and as we saw, it very efficiently removes uromodulin and thus provides high purity urinary nanoparticles, which can be a good starting point for downstream applications such as immunoaffinity isolation or PCR or Western blot. And it has a comparable yield with size exclusion chromatography. And a point that I really didn't touch here is, again, the scalability of TFF filters, but the point still stands. And it's been recently also shown that extracellular vesicle corona can play an important role in their functionality. So I would just like to point out that depending on your downstream application, it might be crucial to think about your mode of isolation, and TFF has shown to retain the corona fairly well compared to size exclusion chromatography or ultracentrifugation. Thank you very much for listening.